In this video, we'll go through the most important steps related to creating usable 3D models from raw scans. This is just an overview, so leave a comment if you're interested in a more in-depth tutorial. The process starts on location, where we use professional cameras to take photos of the subject. After that, photos are processed inside the photogrammetry software. Once the 3D model is built, we have to clean it up and export two versions of it. The first one is a high definition mesh with all the surface details, and as such it will be used for projecting, fixing the surface details and baking. The second one will serve you as a reference for the retopology process. Now it's time to fix the surface details on the high definition mesh, that first mesh we exported from the photogrammetry software. Remove the surface artifacts and get rid of the floating geometry. Anything that can cause problems during the baking process should be taken care of. Export the mesh so you can use it together with the low poly mesh for the creation of various maps. Retopology can be a manual or automatic process. It can also be a mix of two. If working in ZBrush, you can use the ZRemesher tool. Before you start with the retopology, it is really important that you don't move, rotate or scale the imported reference model. Otherwise, we won't be able to project the color texture properly onto a new mesh once we get back inside the photogrammetry software. After the retopology is done, it is time to unwrap the low poly model and prepare two different versions of it. One that has all the UV islands packed inside of a single UV space, and the other one that uses UDIN tiles. Spend some extra time to create a high poly version of the model as well as all the LODs while keeping the UVs. We're ready to texture both a single UV and UDIM version of the high poly mesh, so we'll go back inside the photogrammetry software to do it. The higher the definition of the mesh, the better and more precise the color texture will be. After the models have been textured and exported, we can use software such as Substance Painter to fix the trouble areas. If you know how, you can do it in ZBrush as well. It's baking time. If you use Substance Designer, you will find it to be a very simple process. Of course, you'll have to repeat this step for the UDIM version as well. Create a new package and then add your low poly model to it. Select it, right click and choose Bake Model Information. A new window will appear. Select the high definition mesh, the one you fixed inside ZBrush. Set the proper resolution, anti-aliasing, ray distance and other parameters. Now you can add bakers to the list. Don't forget to add both OpenGL and DirectX version of the normal map. You can also set the correct naming and the target directory path. The correct naming is especially important for UDIM textures. Hit the Start Render button. Import all the meshes inside Blender or your preferred 3D program. Set the proper naming for all the objects, UVs and materials. At least add the albedo and normal maps to the material. Now it's also the right time to adjust the position, scale and rotation. The objects should be facing forward, so all the most important features are visible in the front view. The origin has to be set in the middle of the mass, which is especially important for the closed meshes. You can set it the same for the open meshes or at the bottom center if it makes more sense. Check everything one more time and export all the models as FBX. Make sure to set the geometry smoothing to face, otherwise you'll get an error when importing to Unreal Engine. Last thing to add are the preview images. Make sure that all the files inside the package have the correct names. That's it.